In the fall of 1981, Larry and I were invited by New York University dance historian Sally Summers to Mama Lou Park's annual Lindy event in Harlem. Al was on the floor social dancing. Larry and I were mesmerized by his dancing and asked Sally to introduce us. We asked him if he taught his style of dancing anywhere, and he said no. We asked him if he would come downtown and teach us privately, and thank goodness he said yes. Al began teaching Paul Grecki, Larry, and me at my dance studio. We quickly realized that what he was doing was nothing like the swing that had been passed on to us in the 1950s. Yes, there were some similarities, but what he was doing was so superior in every way. His movement quality, musicality, the endlessly fascinating original dance steps of the Savoy in the 30s and 40s. We had no YouTube back then, so Larry, Paul, and I had no idea this way of doing the Lindy even existed. Larry became Al's manager. Sally Summers suggested Sugar Sullivan, a 1955 Harvest Moon Ball Jitterbug Jive champion, as his partner. They appear in the next piece, written and produced by Larry.
One of the legendary dancers of Harlem's Savoy Ballroom, Al Minns, is coming out of retirement. Minns is appearing this weekend with a new dance company and a special tribute to his old stomping ground, the Savoy. Pia Lindstrom reports. Al Minns, at age 61, is dancing again. Dancing the Big Apple, the Lindy, the Charleston, and the Shim Sham. Minns knows all the jazz dances, from the cakewalk to the twist. His appearance this weekend with a new company, Dance in New York, at the Theater of the Riverside Church, marks his first stage appearance in 7 years. Al Minns grew up in Harlem, dancing at the Savoy Ballroom. In 1938, he met Leon James, another great Savoy dancer, and the team traveled throughout the world, appearing in nightclubs, theaters, Hollywood films, jazz festivals, and on television. In the 1960s, declining interest in the Lindy and other jazz dances idled the team. Al Minns left dancing in 1974 when his partner died. He held several jobs and lived in several different places before retiring completely and moving to this house here in Jamaica, Queens. Minns lives quietly in a small apartment with his dog, Snoopy.
Why are you coming out of retirement now?
Number one was boredom. Retirement, I think the worst thing that can happen to a person when they retire is they become bored and listless and angry, too. Because all your friends, they're busy doing something. And if they're not busy, you sit around, you look at each other, you've got nothing to talk about. I mean, what did you do yesterday? Same thing I did today. I mean, what are you doing today? Same thing I did yesterday, the day before, and the day before, you know? Yeah. This way gives me something to think about.
Al Minns' new partner, Sugar Sullivan, is a great Savoy dancer in her own right, a 1956 Harvest Moon Ball Jitterbug champion. She remembers, as a teenager, watching Minns at the Savoy. Some young members of the Dance in New York company had never seen the Lindy or even heard of the Savoy. Working with Minns has been an inspiration.
I think one of the most special things about Al Minns is that he has a quality of heart that comes out, or a gut relationship to what he's doing. And it shows on his face and it shows in his body. And I think it's particularly true among older performers who have the kind of backlog or the kind of experience in performing that Al has.
Looks forward to teaching in his new career, passing on the Lindy and other jazz dances to future generations. Pia Lindstrom, News 4, New York.
Now, I'd say that's coming out of retirement. Al Menz, Sugar Sullivan, and the Dance in New York Company performed Saturday and Sunday night at the Theater of the Riverside Church in Manhattan.